Name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious. Today we will discuss MCQs on chapter number 7, that is oscillation. We will discuss round about 50 MCQs that all will be important for ETA and other entities. First of all, we will write few terms, just names for ETA and other entities, and you must remember that according about oscillation. The time required by a body to complete one vibration is called time period. You must remember simple definition of time period. That is different for different oscillatory system. And the number of vibration completed by a body in 1 second is called frequency. Its unit is cycle for second. Or hertz, also we can write is CPS, matlab mean cycle per second. The number of cycle accomplished in 1 second is called cycle per second, its unit of frequency. We also call it hertz. So it can be came in ETA or other entities that what is unit of frequency. Frequency first unit cycle per second, second option CPS, third option hertz, option D all of these. So all of these are correct answer. Angular frequency, this is different term. Angular frequency denoted by W, which is further equal to 2 pi f, that means omega is directly proportional to frequency, and frequency is inversely proportional to time period. So omega is directly proportional to frequency and omega is inversely proportional to time period. So in MCQs number 2 arise that choose correct. Omega is directly proportional to f, omega is inversely proportional to f, and omega is directly proportional to t, and option D none of. So the option is right. For simple harmonic motion, the acceleration is directly proportional to the distance from mean position or amplitude, and here we will write minus sign because acceleration is always directed toward mean position. Acceleration is always directed toward mean position. So simple harmonic equation, MCQs number 3, simple harmonic equation or equation is A is directly proportional to x, A is directly proportional to minus x, A is directly proportional to 1 over x, A is directly proportional to 1 over minus x. So the right answer is A is directly proportional to minus x. Now a time period equation which is for oscillatory system is, we know that t is equal to 2 pi divided by omega, where 2 is number which is constant, 5 is also number, 3.14 or 22/7, that is also constant, but omega is different for different oscillatory system. For example, the omega, we can write the same omega for mass spring system and simple pendulum. For simple pendulum, it is G divided by L under root N. k divided by m for mass spring system. So the time period equation for mass spring system became T is equal to 2 by under root m by k, and T is equal to 2 by under root L by g. We will discuss it later, it's different cases, but here we must note the velocity equation for simple harmonic motion. For simple harmonic motion, we can write the velocity equation as v is equal to omega, where omega is 2 pi f n r square, r amplitude, minus x square. So MCQ is number 4, that choose correct equation for velocity. Option A, v is equal to r square minus x square, v is equal to omega r square plus x square, v is equal to omega r square minus x square, and v is equal to 1 over omega r square minus x square. The correct option is option C. R, choose the correct equation, but here number 1 is v is equal to omega r square minus x square, v square is equal to omega square into r square minus x square, and C, both of these, and D, none of these. Here we will just take square root, or they can also give the same MCQs yet, but in this form. But the same case, the option C is right. Next MCQ is number 6, that is also related to velocity. For simple pendulum, we will consider two points, point A and point B. The point A, which is point of amplitude, and point which is at mean position. At point A, the velocity equation became, at point A, the velocity equation v is equal to omega r square minus x square. Here x is equal to r at point A, and the ball is at a extreme, where x is r, or x is equal to a, x is equal to r, so v becomes omega into r square minus ar square, which is omega into 0 under root is equal to 0. It means at extreme position or amplitude, the velocity is 0, and in mean position v is equal to omega r square minus 0 square, omega is equal to under root r square. So MCQ number 6 is velocity is minimum at point A, B, C, D, extreme position, option B, mean position, option C, when x is equal to 1 over 2 r, and option D, none of these. So we already proved that velocity is minimum or 0 at mean position. And MCQ number 7, velocity is maximum at mean position, velocity is minimum at extreme position, that is 0, and velocity is maximum at mean position. So in simple pendulum, the ball start from extreme position and passes through mean position with high velocity and stop at extreme again, where its velocity become zero, and start again, and hence the cycle continues. So two MCQs are more important, that where velocity is maximum and where velocity is minimum. It is maximum at mean position and minimum at extreme position. R MCQs number 8. MCQs number 8. If we double the frequency, what will happen to velocity? It will double, it will be quadruples. Option C, it will become half, and option D, it will remain same. So we can solve it as, we already know that V is equal to omega R square minus X square. Omega is equal to 2 pi F R square minus X square. By doubling the frequency 2F R square minus X square, we can write it 2 pi F is equal to R square minus X square. 2 times that up velocity. So the velocity double. So by doubling the frequency, what will happen to the velocity? It will be also double. If it is 1 meter per second, then it will become 2 meter per second. If it is 2 meter per second, then it will become 4 meter per second. Done. Now for time period equation for simple pendulum, we will discuss different MCQs now for simple pendulum. This is simple pendulum. At extreme position or at lateral amplitude, the force in the string is tension. Here the weight downward x, also on the bob or mass. By resolving the components of W into its Wx and Wy, we will get Wx and Wy. It's theta, it is same as this one. So here the restoring force act in this direction, applied force, sorry, and restoring force in this direction. So MCQ number 10 states from the graph that the force of tension in the string in mass pendulum is cancelled by option A Wx, option B Wy, and option C what will we get about the option C? F restoring, option D none of these. So from the graph we see the tension in the string is cancelled by Wx component of weight of the body. So the right MCQ is Wx, and the Wy component cancel the effect of F applied. For this one MCQ is most important for eta and other entities. Here we wrote this plane is parallel, but in actual the path followed is circular type. So we consider the amplitude small, in carrying the calculation of simple pendulum. So we can also consider that this path is equal to, this is linear path, not circular path. So MCQs number 11 in calculation for time period or any other calculation of simple pendulum, the quantity that is kept small is speed, number 2 frequency, number 3 amplitude, number D length. So we consider amplitude is small, because if the amplitude is small, we can write sin theta is equal to theta. So the quantity that is kept small in for any types of calculation of simple pendulum is amplitude. The next is time period. We know that T is equal to 2 pi divided by omega. Omega is equal to G by L. T is equal to 2 pi under root G by L. So the equation become T is equal to 2 pi L divided by G under root. From the equation, it is crystal clear that T doesn't depend, or T is independent of mass. So MCQs number 11 became: choose the correct equation for a time period. That is time period that is so simple. T is equal to 2 pi L divided by G. MCQ number 12. Choose the correct equation. That is T is equal to 2 pi divided by 2 pi under root L divided by G. MCQ number 13. If we double if we quadruple the length of pendulum, a length of pendulum, what will happen to time period? Yeah, point T new. We know that T is equal to 2 pi under root L by G by quadrupling 4 L divided by G. We can also write T is equal to 2 pi L divided by G. T is equal to 2 pi L divided by G is T. So T nu is equal to 2 times of T. So by quadrupling the length of the pendulum, the time period becomes double. So if it is 1 second, it will become 2 second. If it is 2 second, it will become 4 times. There are two terms which is used in eta in other t-tests. That is first pendulum, second pendulum, third pendulum, so on. First pendulum. What is first pendulum? First pendulum. First pendulum is that pendulum of which time period is equal to 1 second. And second pendulum is that pendulum of which time period is equal to 2 seconds. If a body completes its total rotation in 1 second, we call the pendulum as first pendulum. And if it completes rotation in 2 seconds, we call it second pendulum. So T is equal to 2 pi L divided by G under root. For first pendulum, T is equal to 2 pi under root L divided by 9.8. Pi is equal to 3.14. So 1 is equal to 2 3s are 6.28 under root L divided by under root 9.8. It will be like 0.25 meter. So you can't use calculator in eta, that's why you have to remember it. So in the same way, you can also find time period for second pendulum by putting the values such as T, that is 2 second, 2 multiplied by 3.14 under root L divided by under root 9.8. this is your homework, or I will solve it and post it on our Facebook page, that is Bank of MCQs. The next MCQs, this is MCQ number 14. This is MCQ number 15. So, MCQ number 16 is, if we quadruple the length of the pendulum and also quadruple the gravity, or MCQ number 15, if we double length and also double the G value, we can't use it, but we suppose that we have changed the G value. So the new T is equal to 2 pi L by G. T is equal to 2 pi 2 L by 2 G, 2 pi L by G. So option 2 pi under root L by G is right. MCQ is number 16. This is so important according to my view. Find the ratio of time period, ratio of time period on moon, or time period on earth of pendulum, on earth of pendulum to T moon, time period on moon for same pendulum. Remember that gravity on moon is equal to gravity on earth divided by 6. G on moon is equal to G on earth divided by 6. Gravity is 6 times lesser than that of earth. G on moon is equal to 1 by 6 G earth. So the equation for moon is T is equal to 2 pi L divided by G by 6. We can also write that T is equal to 2 pi 6 L by G, also is under root 6 2 pi L by G, that is on earth, under root 6 T on earth and T on moon. Now T on moon is equal to under root 6 multiply T on earth. So the equation ratio of T earth to T moon, so 1 divided by under root 6 is equal to T earth divided by T moon, not 6 times because there is under root. MCQ is number 17. This is so important also. For second pendulum, for second pendulum, remember this word, for second pendulum, if we quadruple, if we increase length of second pendulum 16 times, then what will be, then what will be time period, time period. So T is equal to 2 pi L by G. By putting T is equal to 4 pi under root 16 by G under root, under root 16 will become 4, T is equal to 2 pi L by G, it will become 4 times 4T. But options, they give options such as option A, 4 second, option B, 3 second, option C, 2 times, option D, none of these. You can see there is no option like such as time period is increased 4 times. So for second pendulum, Second pendulum means the rest time period is equal to 2 seconds. So putting t is equal to 2 seconds, it becomes 8 seconds. So I can make option is 8 seconds. So the correct option is 8 seconds. If they give the same MCQs, but they just write that find the time period for first pendulum. Check in this case, they will give that for first pendulum, we increase length by 16 times or 4 times. In this case, we increase length by 4 times. Then the time period is t is equal to 2 pi 4 l by g under the root. Here t is equal to 2 pi l by g, t is equal to t. The time period will become double of its original value. But what is original value? We don't know. But they have given this first pendulum. First pendulum means time period is 1 second. So if it is 1 second, it will become double. So 2 ones are 2. It will become 2 seconds. Here it is second pendulum, it means time period is 2 seconds. And we know that by increasing 16 times, time period become 4 times. 4 twos are 8. So option is 8 seconds. MCQs number 17. That if we double the length, if we double mass, if we double the mass, what will be the happen to the time period? So we know that t is equal to 2 pi under root l divided by g. So option R, if we double the mass, then what time period will be? Double half same and none of these. So if we double the mass, time period remain same. Time period become double, half remain same. So if there is no mass in the equation, we know the time period is independent of mass for simple pendulum. So option C is right. But MCQs number 18, if the same MCQ is right, time period for simple pendulum. If we double the mass, yeah, if we quadruple the mass for mass spring system, what will happen to the t? So we know that t is equal to 2 pi under root m by k for mass system. So t is equal to 2 pi 4 m by k, it is t is equal to 2 pi m by k. So 2 times the t. So by quadrupling the mass spring system becomes double. Are we double, quadruples, or we increase 100 times the mass, so we know for simple pendulum time period is independent mass. So if we double the mass, quadruple the mass, or 100 times, nothing will happen to time period of mass simple pendulum. MCQs number 19. If we increase mass 16 times for both mass spring system, and simple pendulum, find ratio of T2 per mass spring system to T2 of simple pendulum. So option A, B, C, D. First we will solve it. then we will write complex options related to solution. So time period of mass spring system divided by time period of sample pendulum that is required. We know that T is equal to 2 pi under root m by k. T is equal to 2 pi under root L by g. So by increasing 16 times the mass nutting with help happen to this time period of sample pendulum, so it will remain the same. But if we increase 16 times mass of mass spring system, it will become 16 under root m by k, so it will become 4t. So t cancel with t, it will become 4 or 4 divided by 1. So the option 1 is 4:1, 1:4, 1:1, none of these. So option 1 is right. Remember, 4:1 is not is equal to 1:4, and you will choose the answer at bar word is given first and second. So mass spring system and sample pendulum, so mass spring system divided by sample pendulum. If the same question is written, but if they change the order of sample pendulum in mass spring system, then the answer will be reverse. Okay, next, energy conservation in simple harmonic motion. It is also important topic. MCQs number 19 is done. So we, our target is about 50 MCQs, so we will write MCQ number 20 in this case. For energy conservation in simple harmonic motion, we know that potential energy first we will find, which is potential energy is equal to W is equal to FD. Here D is equal to X naught, where F is average force, simple is initial, final divided by 2, where initial is 0, and if final is F is equal to KX naught divided by 2. So W is equal to KX naught divided by 2 multiplied by X naught is equal to half KX naught square. This is the equation of potential energy. So, but you don't need any derivation. You have simple to remember that the potential energy is equal to half KX naught square at extreme, but at any point it is equal to half KX square. So remember, potential energy is equal to half KX square, and there is no need for derivation of kinetic energy, but remember that kinetic energy is equal to half K, same as this, but here X is equal to X naught square minus X square, where X is displacement, X naught is amplitude, and the total energy ET, which is simple sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy, that is half KX naught square jama half KX naught square minus X square. By calculating, it will become half KX naught square. So MCQs number 20. From we can also write more MCQs, such as I will solve it for you people, you must practice it at home. MCQs number 23. MCQs number 23. When is kinetic energy maximum? And when is kinetic energy minimum or zero? At extreme position, we know that kinetic energy is equal to half KX naught square minus X square. Here X naught is amplitude. We can also write it as half KA square minus X square whole under root. So at extreme position, it will become half KA square minus, here displacement is also equal to amplitude, A square minus A square. So half KA square minus A square is equal to 0, so it is equal to the 0. So kinetic energy is minimum or 0 at option A, extreme, option B, extreme, extreme A, mean, option C, A is equal to x by 2, option D, A is equal to x divided by under root 2. So kinetic energy is minimum is mean position. Option, so now at mean position the equation become is half is equal to half k a square minus, here x is equal to 0, 0 square, so half k a square at its maximum value of kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is equal to maximum at mean position. 23, 24 done. MCQs number 25, that is really, really, really important for ETA. It also came in ETA 2019, ETA 2019, ETA 2013, ETA 2012, and ETA 2009. And his equal probability date, it may came in MCQs number 25. It's so important. They ask that at what position kinetic energy is equal to potential energy. See, at this position we know that whole point is at high speed, so its kinetic energy is maximum and potential energy is equal to zero. And at this position, extreme position, we know that its kinetic energy is equal to zero, but potential energy is equal to maximum. Here potential energy is zero and here potential energy is maximum. From moving from point mean to extreme position, the potential energy increases and the kinetic energy decreases. The one, potential energy, it decreases, but kinetic energy increases. At we have to point this point where kinetic energy is equal to potential energy. So we will write that kinetic energy is equal to half k x naught square minus x square. Potential energy is equal to half k x square. Half k cancel with half k, half k. We will write x naught a square minus x square is equal to x square. So a square is equal to x square plus x square. A square is equal to 2 times of x square. X square 2 times of x square is equal to a square. So more on x square is equal to a square divided by 2, taking the square x is equal to a divided by under root 2. So option A is x is equal to a, option B x is equal to a by 2, option C x is equal to a divided by under root 2, option D none of these. You can't guess the answer, but if someone guess, he will guess this position, which is x by x naught by 2. You know that x is equal to a divided by under root 2, where kinetic energy is equal to potential energy. MCQ is number 27. Find the point at which potential energy is 2 times that of kinetic energy. Option A, B, C, D. We will let option A is x divided by under root 2. That is where kinetic energy is equal to potential energy, and I will write the rest of MCQ option is later. First we will solve it. Potential energy is equal to 2 times that of kinetic energy. Potential energy is equal to half kx square. Kinetic energy 2 times that of half kx naught square minus x square. Half k cancelled with half k. X square is equal to 2 x naught square minus x square. X square is equal to 2x naught square minus 2x square. 2x naught square is equal to x square plus 2x square. 3x square is equal to 2x naught square, x naught or a square. So here x square is equal to 2 by 3 a square, and x is equal to, by taking the square, 2 by 3 a. So option 2 is 2 by 3 a, x is equal to half a, x is equal to 1 by 2 by 3 a. So option B is right, and option B is that point where potential energy is double of kinetic energy. MCQ number 27. Find the point at where kinetic energy is double of potential energy. If kinetic energy is double of potential energy, then we will write it, 2 time potential energy is equal to kinetic energy. So the equation becomes 2x square is equal to x naught square minus x square. We will also write it as 2x square is equal to x naught square minus x square. Taking into left side, it will become 2x square plus x square. So 3x square is equal to a square. Here x square is equal to a square divided by 3. So x is equal to a divided by under root 3. So a divided by under root 3 is the right option, at which 2 time potential kinetic energy is double up potential energy. They can also write the MCQ point the point where kinetic energy is triple up potential energy, or potential is equal triple up kinetic energy, but the procedure is same as here. Now there is no more important MCQs in this case. The topic remaining is resonant frequency, that is important, but you must remember it. Examples of frequency are, which one of the following, which one of the following, which one of the following works on principle of resonance? Option A, radio. Yes, when we rotate its knob, when its frequency is equal to the source frequency, its energy is, energy absorbed is maximum, and the sounds appear here. Or option B, magnetic resonance image, we call it MRI. This is also example, it also works on resonance. Option C, cooking of food in microwave oven, or simply oven. And option D, all of these. So microwave oven, MRI, and radio, all of these works on resonance. And at resonance, the energy absorbed is, energy absorbed at resonance is maximum. Now we will damped oscillation, force oscillation, and sharpness of resonance. We will write, explain 2 more MCQs, so the chapter will end here. If there is something else, we will give a single touch to it in next video. MCQs number 29, that is related to damped oscillation, or the oscillation of which amplitude decrease, it eventually becomes zero. So the amplitude of damped oscillation is option A, never becomes zero. Zero at end. Option C, remains same. Option D, none of these. So in damp oscillation, the amplitude at last become zero. MCQ is number 30. Which one of the following is correct equation? Sharpness of resonance, where it is damped small or medium damping or heavy damping, or what is the damping relation with amplitude? So amplitude, choose correct amplitude, where A shows amplitude, A is inversely proportional to damping, or A is directly proportional to damping, or A is directly proportional to 2 times of damping, or A doesn't depend on damping. So option D is, option A is right, because if you have small damping, then amplitude will get its maximum. If you have less medium, or if you have minimum or heavy damping. So always remember that amplitude is inversely proportional to damping. So here is the end of our chapter, and we discuss about 30 MCQ.